senator may make a personal explanation, though there be no question before the Senate. But though controversial matter may be brought forward, nor may debate arise upon the explanation. The terms of the proposed statement shall be submitted in detail to the President of the Senate when his leave to make it sought. Now, Mr. President, I carefully listened to the letter sent from the Presidency, and I am to make this observation based on this order. First of all, I am the chairman of the Senate Ad Hoc Committee on Mounting Humanitarian Crisis in the northeastern part of Nigeria. And it is shocking to me that such a letter can come from the Presidency with such default misinformation and outright distortion. Before me here, I will raise these two issues from that letter. They lied by saying that we didn't invite the SGF. The committee invited the SGF, and the letter was acknowledged by a permanent secretary in the office of the SGF in the person of Mr. Aminu Nabegu, and I have this letter with me as an acknowledgement, and I will submit that to the clerk. And secondly, to make sure that we buttress our point, we made a paid advert in 3 to 4 national dailies. This one was published on the 2nd of December 2016, and the SGF is clearly mentioned as one of those who are invited to come and appear before the committee. So, if they have the intention of simply reaching a predetermined conclusion by covering up on the issues raised by the committee, that is one thing. And then secondly, issues were raised that only 3 members of the committee signed that interim report. That was also a second lie coming from the Presidency. And I have with me a copy of the interim report here, which was initially signed by 7 of the 9 or 10 members of that panel. And I'm going to submit it to the clerk of the Senate. And even if it is 9 and then 3 people sign, we still have a quorum. But here I have 7 people. And then I would say also, I listened to the list of the names that were read, and they omitted the chairman, which is myself. I know I'm not very big in frame, but I believe that my name shouldn't have been omitted. So this shows clearly how the SGF and his minions within the Presidency misinformed the President to sign such a letter. This shows the default in that kind of letter. And secondly, I will say this clearly. This letter is a funeral service for the anti-corruption crusade in Nigeria. Mr. President, when it comes to fighting corruption in the National Assembly and the judiciary, and in the larger Nigerian scene, the Presidency uses insecticides. And when it comes to fighting corruption within the Presidency, they use deodorant. That is very unfortunate. And I will say this also. I stand by the report of that committee. And it's very clear to us, if we can allow this committee report to be shredded into pieces, then I think it will be in order for us to open all the 138 prisons in this country for both the convicts and the awaiting trial to go scot-free. As far as I'm concerned, on behalf of myself and the committee, what we did was a thorough job. We invited all the companies concerned. We invited the SGF, and he sent us the secretary of the Presidential Initiative on the Northeast. And the secretary testified under oath that he is competent enough. He came with tons and tons of documents, which we went through, and then we came out with our report. And I will say, it is unfortunate that we have a political atmosphere where you have a saintly and angelic presidency and a devilish and evil society. We must, in every respect, fight corruption within the kitchen as we do in this veranda. If we don't do that, then we have been hypocritical. This letter does not in any way reflect the spirit which we espouse as people, fighting to cleanse and fumigate this country of corruption.